people are getting used to the idea that they do not have a power to elect, that their vote doesn't matter.
The law is given by the constitution and not by the oligarchs.
No one feels that he is important to his country, and everyone feels like to go out, immigrate, and do something in his life without cheating.
There's 200,000 Armenians leaving per year from Armenia. Pretty soon we're going to have no one left in Armenia, and we won't have an Armenia.
We are going to lose this country. Just 1 year is enough, and the half of this nation will go away from this country. Believe me, if it's going to be a Serge Sarkisian, everybody wants to leave his country, their own country.
Հայաստանի Հանրապետությունը այսօր գտնվում է մի խումբ անձանց ձեռքին։ Պետական ամբողջ համակարգը կոռումպացված է վերիցված։ Եվ այս համակարգը մենք պետք է փոխենք։ Մեզ համար անընդունելի է ազգային պետական գործի կերպարը, որը սեփական քաղաքում, սեփական հանրապետությունում շրջում է հաստավիզ ու պետամի տախրանիկներով, ճիպերով ու դուարակներով, պրամուսներով։
The oligarchs have become now so strong that they undermine the state itself. It is the cancer of the state. Within the government, we have a criminal class only getting richer by plundering and pillaging the state. We're far less tolerant in general, but much too tolerant of the oligarchs and the gangsters in suits within the Armenian government.
Այսինքն, եթե իշխանությունը ամենաթողություն է թույլ տալիս, դա նրա արդյունքում, որ մենք բոլորս նրան թույլ ենք տալիս դա անել.
What we are having in Armenia, unfortunately, is not a democracy, it's a dictatorship.
All court levels under control of one person, of the parliament's 26, of the presidential office. How the president will say, the courts will decide it in such way.
It's more than 20 years that Armenia never had a new president through elections.
The elections are falsified regularly.
Republican Party, Prosperous Armenia, they are not at all supportive to the public. They are the oligarchic parties who are in the power and supporting the big business and the officials, not with the people.
Going back to the first term of Robert Kocharyan, that's when the Republican Party began putting their own people in offices so they could make sure to have very tight control over the society.
Last important event was 2008 presidential elections, when the elections were rigged. Then they staged first March killings, and 10 people were killed.
The main violation during the recent three or four elections, it was the voters list, where are too much people who are not in country, but actually sometimes after election, their relatives are reporting that they come from, like from USA, they vote and they went, but how they did it, nobody knows.
People are taking bribes, for example, of $10 to sell their voice. So they say, it doesn't matter, it's not going to change anything, so I can take the bribe and go and vote for Republicans.
A lot of people also fear of losing their jobs, you know? I was a teacher, university teacher, and I lost my job because I dared to speak out. I used to say to my students that people who attend rallies, they are not beggars. They are free thinkers, they are intellectuals, they are highly educated people. So my students used to believe me. This is why my director of the university was afraid of having me there. He said, oh no, your influence is very bad. You are speaking about freedom, about democracy. This is very bad for students.
Why do they think it's bad?
Because he said to me, you know, let them raise naive, because they can be a bit, it will be easy to govern, it will be easy
they
to rule.
They can be controlled.
Yes, this is why, the reason. They are feared of democracy. They cannot stand the word even.
So unless people change this mentality, we are never going to have free and fair elections.
Armenia is facing a very important election, a presidential election set for February 18th, 2013. Many people widely expect, although not necessarily favor, the re-election of Serge Sargsyan as president. We do have three levels of candidates here. In the first group, we have only one person, incumbent President Serge Sargsyan himself. In the second group, we have former Foreign Minister Rafi Hovhannisyan, Armenia's first foreign minister and the leader of the opposition Heritage Party, and we have Hrant Bagratyan, a former prime minister under President Levonte Petrosyan. We also have a third group of candidates. First, Bayut Harigyan, a very prominent Soviet period dissident who was actually more active and more well known during the Soviet period. We also have Andreas Gukasyan, who's actually very interesting in terms of a private citizen running a private radio station. In many political countries and cultures, a hunger strike is a weapon of last resort. In his case, it's a weapon of first resort.
Yes, Pahanjelem, or Saksusuna, Ishok Saksun, or Ansalan Trusunerum, Yakanatrele, Akasamanadrakan, Gorzneutsun, Pajanele and Drakashartner, Arkadrele. Պետական ծառայողներին քվեարկել իրոքտին, իսկ դա քրեորեն պատժելի առարկներ են։ Այստեղ պաշտպանում եմ հիմա, արտահայտել եմ իմ պրոտեստը ացադուլով, որովհետև պետությունը հրաժարվեց մերժել այդ կուսակցության մասնակցությունը դրություններում։
We also have Arman Malikian, a former foreign minister of Nagorno-Karabakh, who has run in every election, it seems. We also have Aram Harutyunyan, who is also pulled out of the race early, leaving the field after particular realism in recognition that he has no real support. We also have a specialist on epic mythology and poetry, who is actually as exotic and unpredictable as his background suggests. He refuses to accept the results of the election, even if he's elected.
Why would someone enter a campaign race and also say he wouldn't accept the position?
That's a good question, but it's a good question that deserves an answer from the candidate, and to date, he has not.
You know, we have our own results for public pollings. They are the results of recent surveys conducted by very independent organizations, and they say that if elections are free and fair, then Rafi will win in the first round.
Şansı var neyim? Şansı 195 խմբեմ, 77-60 էտա.
The only highlight of a rather lackluster, non-competitive campaign was the shooting of one of the candidates.
You are candidate for president of Armenia, and you were shot. Tell us what happened. Just briefly.
Briefly, okay. I take my briefcase, closed door, and I saw somebody, and a gun. From meter, only 1 meter. I understand that I have no time. I only cry strongly, hey, and try to disturb him, but he shot. When he shot, I feel that I lost my energy. And there was a second shot. And second shot come from here, that it didn't come in. First was from here, and bullet was here. After surgery, they take out bullet.
Tomorrow you will speak to the people.
But I am not sure how many people will be there.
And why is Baron Harikyan different than others?
Որտեղ Պարոն Հարիկյանի ծրագրերի հիմքում կած է ժողովրդավարությունը, ազատությունն ու անկախությունը։
And this music is him singing and he wrote this music.
Դա Պարոն Հարիկյանի գրած երաժշտությունն է եւ բառերը։
I think it's amo to do this.
Why?
Because it's, you know, foolish. All Armenian channels, TV channels are run by the authorities, you know. And Armenian authorities, they make such image of rallies as if people who attend rallies, they are pariahs, they are beggars, you know. This is why people are afraid of being there. They try to be a bit outside, just following what's going on here.
Again,
protest, protest till the end again.
Do you believe that will help?
No, I don't think so.
Do you believe in any of the candidates? Do you think any of them are good?
No, I don't think so. But I believe that this president now. I don't want to tell the name, but it's okay.
I want Rafi to be the president of Armenia.
I would like to see people getting jobs because the rate of unemployment here in Armenia is very big.
When we're making meetings, by the way, people came to her, Rafi Ovansyan, people came to her some political things. They're interested in politics, but not in concert. And when it's coming time for concert, the hall is becoming half empty.
Հինգ տարի անց, ինչպես աղետի գոտին պիտի պատկանի մեր առուտներին, մեր սրդերին և մեր պատմաքրքերին, բայց այլևս պիտի ապրենք զարգացած քաղաքում և մարզում.
What does it say on there?
To the Safe Armenia.
Safe Armenia,
okay.
We all want that. Who are the people that are coming to this concert?
I don't know, they are coming to help meeting with the president, maybe the last 10. There will be a concert and I hope it will be interesting.
And these people were told to come by their boss, school?
There are people who are working in different places, so I hope yes.
You think yes?
Yes.
Mostly people who are going to meetings with Sir Sarkisian are going, let's say not by force, but not by their will. They're, for example, teachers in schools, or they're working in governmental structures, in kindergartens, or in supermarkets that have owners from Republican Party. They say, hey, you have to go to meeting with Sir Sarkisian or with Republican Party. In other case, you'll be fired. So they're going, they're just sitting there. Of course, it's not interesting for them. They're not interested to listen to Sir Sarkisian. They're going there because they can't say no.
Why do you vote for Sarkisian? Why is he good president? Angle Jose.
I don't know.
All right,
how are you, Jose? What is new topic? What are you doing? Շնորհակալ եմ որ այստեղ եք, շնորհակալ եմ որ սանարում եք, շնորհակալ եմ բոլորին։ Երբ Հայաստանցին հայտնում էր փողոցում, այս անցյալն եմ փորձում ձեզ հրամցնել որպես ապագա, ընտրություն ապագայի ու անցյալի միջև, և այն է ներվել ձեր ընտրությունը։
People want to hear some concert. But not the speech of Sir Sarkisian.
I think it was so because the people were told to come to the meeting with him. I think that the people are so interested in his programs.
They were interested in seeing a concert.
Yes, maybe. Let's be sure.
And you worked for him. You worked in the campaign. No. You don't want to talk about that. Okay, check please.
We are not bringing people by forcing them.
Well, he's the only one who has a platform, he's the only one who campaigns, he's the only one who actually asks economists to build his economic plans. I mean, what are we comparing him to exactly? It's the same as Stalin and Brezhnev or Rafi Ovanisyan, really.
In the city of Goris, surprisingly, no Armenian citizen turned out. That region and that city in particular live under constant fear of the regional governor. In fact, don't forget, all the regional governors are presidentially appointed, none are elected, by preventing and coercing the people not to turn out for Hovhannissian, the counter-reaction will be only to make him more popular on a deeper level.
Well, it's election day, and it's 10:30 a.m. Streets in midtown Yerevan are kind of empty, and a few people have come in here to this local polling station to vote. Hello.
Hello.
What is your name?
Vilena Toya.
Did you vote today?
Yes.
Did you enjoy?
Yes.
And do you believe election is fair?
Yeah.
So these are additional voter lists.
Additional voter lists.
Yes. You can apply if you live in other community.
We have around 59 additional voters, and all of them already came and voted.
Have you ever seen in other countries the electorate in pre-election surveys do not voice their true opinion because they don't want to be heard saying anything against the current president?
Yeah, no, that's common. I live in Russia. A stranger comes up to someone on the street and says, "You're going to vote for Vladimir Putin?" You either tell you, "Get out of my face," or, "Of course I will." It's a very tricky thing to get accurate surveys, even exit surveys.
What are you doing here at the polling station?
We ask people some questions to know a result before official process.
You ask them after they vote?
Yes, after they vote only.
And what do you ask them?
Whom they voted for, when they decided to vote, and their age.
And then you will tell the results at 8 o'clock tonight?
Yes.
And then what if the results are different than the official results?
I don't know.
At 8 o'clock, when all precincts are closed already, the findings of this exit poll were virtually on all TV channels, indicating that the incumbent received 58% of the vote, the exact number that later CEC announced, official number. But you remember how many people were willing to answer to the exit polls. They are not open to say who they voted for. They are afraid maybe because in some cases they might lose their job or they don't have problems with their neighbors, relatives. It's a different culture. And exit polls cannot work here, let alone to predict the result with the 1% correctness. A lot of Western media announced the results based on exit polls. It is very possible that someone in BBC will not know the difference between exit polls in UK and in Armenia, and who organized and who paid for exit polls.
The Republic of Armenia and its citizens have decided to take their destiny, our destiny, into our hands. Finally, to have a de jure presidency that recognizes the rule of rights and the rule of law. At the same time, we demand the rule of rights for our own citizens. And for the first time in 20 years, the citizens have said yes to our constitution, yes to the rule of law, yes to democracy in our future. This struggle, this victory, which I claim today, belongs to the Armenian people, to the citizen of Armenia. Thank you.
President Sargsyan was roundly re-elected according to the election results. Surprisingly, however, Armenia's first foreign minister, Rafi Hovhannisyan, emerged with 36% of the vote.
Okay, as always, they make the fraudulent elections, as always. And so the people came to protest and to say that they do not want to live in Armenia, which is fraudulent, which is corrupt. They want to live in free Armenia.
We're against this system of oligarchy and criminals who are forging the results of our elections. There were more than like 300 cases of abuse, you know, power abuse, forgeries, etc. So we're against all this, shit.
Our election, you are now violated by Sir Sargsyan.
Okay, so something we can call election or something like an election, there were lots of violations.
Do you think the violations made the difference?
Yeah, sure. Because in the election committees, when we were strong, where we had good staff, we protected our votes. We protected the votes of voters, the votes of people, and the opposition win there. In the committees where we was not so strong, we lose there.
Gyumri, the second largest city, turned out in over 70% of the vote behind Hovhannisyan. At the same time, he won the third largest city of Vanadzort, three key districts of Yerevan. Serge lost in those cities because voters had an opportunity to cast their ballots the way they wanted, and they were counted more than before.
The OSCE analysis showed a correlation between the very high turnout and the number of votes for the incumbent. For Serge Sargsyan, the voter turnout is greatly inflated. I mean, there are some voting stations with 100% voter turnout. This is rather unlikely.
Unlike 2008, this is a dynamic, spontaneous eruption of discontent in general.
Մենք եկել ենք պայքարելու մեր Հայաստանի, մեր հայրենիքի համար. Մենք պիտի չհամաչենք, որ այս երկրում ենք ապրում. Մենք շատ ենք ցավում, որ նման իշխանություններ ունենք. Մեզ պետք է նորմալ իշխանություն, մարդկային, մարդկանց իրավունքները հարգող իշխանություն, ոչ թե այսօրվա նման ավազակներ.
Ով ժամանակի շուտ չամփայն խմեց, շրավորեց գողացված ընդրության, որ նա զավթողը ինքը ֆխշալու է այս ժողովրդի առջև. Ես պատրաստ եմ իր հետ հանդիպել ժողովրդի իշխանությունը փոխանցելու պայմանները իր հետ որոշելու համար.
Hovhannisyan, as opposition leader, had a very significant meeting personally with President Sargsyan. Hovhannisyan was very civil, was smiling, shook the hand of the president. Sargsyan and his political elite have never faced an opponent like Hovhannisyan.
Arkankov Anders,
ասացին ճանաչեք ժողովրդի հաղթանակը պատասխանը ոչ ասացին շամպայն խմելու փոխարեն նոր ընտրություն պատասխանը ոչ
Առաջորդն ասել եմ հետևյալը Ռաֆի մինչև անելիկներին արթնելը ես երկու հարց ունեմ Հարց առաջին դու հաղթել ես ընտրություններում ասեց ոչ ասեցի բա ինչ ա եղել ասեց մերոնք ասում են որ դուք էլ չեք հաղթել ասեցի Ռաֆի Դու չես հաղթել, ես չեմ հաղթել, բա ո՞վ է հաղթել։
We did an observation mission. They stayed there the whole day.
What did they notice during their full observation?
Many things. One is human carousel. It's when groups of people are brought to different polling stations and they vote more than one time. In some cases they hold different passports. In others the stamp can be erased because this time the stamp could be erased by a wet napkin. Yes, it could.
Կամ փոխել օրենքը եւ կիրառել սովորական չցնդող քանակներ.
Our observers say that there were bribing in regions mainly.
Taking the election bribe is a crime, but giving bribe is not a crime. Just because of government wants to protect those guys who give the bribes for the government by the law.
Oops, okay. Check.
Ես դա դրա համար
բան ասում ենք ի՞նչ ցուցակներ։
Ի՞նչ ցուցակ։
Ցուցակ է, նկարել ենք արդեն։
Նկարել ենք, բայց ի՞նչ ցուցակ։ Մեկ իրավունք ունեք ցուցակ արարի ցուցակ։
Հարցնում եմ։
Դե հարցրա։
Usually normal people, ordinary population doesn't go to the parties and ask for bribe, but parties are coming and offering money, different services in order to vote for themselves.
Do you know that there was money paid to people for
vote? My husband was personally offered 50,000 AMD on Kera Street to vote for Ser Sarkisyan.
Ինչ են պասպորտի ծերային հավաքում, հա?
Պասպորտի ծերային հավաքում ընդրատեղ համաձայն ցուցակների համարն են հավաքում.
Իսկ
որոնք ինչ են, էլի չէ՞ ես։ Գործող նախագահին քվյարկի 5000 դրամ փոխարտած։
Հա։ Իսկ կոնկրետ ասեմ։
Կարող է եւ ավելն է 10 դառնա, էլի։
Այդպես են ասել։
Հա։ Մուսայելան փողոցի վրա, Ղանդիլան փողոցի վրա։ Եղավ։
Ձեր անուն ազգանունը կասեք։
Էլի հեշ պետք չէ։
Ինչի համար։
Եկու թոշակ չեք ձերքեն, դա չեն տա։
Վախենում եք։
Ինչի՞ չեմ վախենա։ Ես երկրում եմ, ով չի վախենա։
I was a chairman of
chairman of a precinct.
Yeah, number 3.33. So, someone from Republican Party, he suggested to me like, "Do you want a new car or do you want something for your family? What can I do for you? Just you should close your eyes for a few minutes." Just to allow us to do whatever we want.
Բոլոր վայրերում կա շարքա բաժանվել, ես դրանից տեղյակ եմ ու բաժանվել է նաև գրիչներ, որ այդ նույն գրիչներով իրանք մարդկանց ստիպել են, որ պետք է այդ նույն գրիչներով ընտրեն, որ այդ գրիչները հետո իրանք ընտրությունից հետո իրանք համար պարզ լինի, դու գնացել ես ընտրության հանրապետական ես ընտրել թե չէ, ու բոլորն էլ վախից ելնելով գնացել ու ընտրել են հանրապետական։ Կաշարքը վերցրել են ու գնացել ընտրել են, որովհետև գյուղի մարտի կախկատ են ու այդ չնչին գումար իրանց աչքին երևում է։ Որովհետև գյուղի մարտը զարգացած չի, որովհետև այսօրվա իշխանությունը իշխանություն չի։
When I give you an election bribe, I will lie to you. I'll say that there is a mini camera in the pen and I will see who do you vote for. There are lots of people mostly in villages who believe that.
Հաջորդ փոշոտ հաղթումը վերաբերում է բաց եւ վերահսկելի քվեարկությանը, որը հիմնականում տեղ էր գտել մարզերում, երբ որ գյուղապետերը որպես կանոն նստում էին մոտիկ քվեախցիկին եւ ուղղորդում էին վերահսկում էին համագյուղացիների քվեարկությունը։
Սամվել Վարդանյան, Արմավիրի մարզի Քարակարի համայնքի ղեկավար։
Was there any concern by the people about the process of election here?
Normal. Վերջում արդյունքները ամփոփելուց կտեսնեք, որ բոլոր տեխնացիաները մեր գյուղում ցայներն են, բայց ով ոնց աշխատի, ով ոնց է իր աշխատանքը ներկայացրել, ընդենց էլ արդյունքները կամ փոփոխստան հան ամենուր իր արժանի գնահատական ավարտ
հասկանալ։ So,
no problem.
Local and regional officials in Armenia know no better than engaging in voting irregularities to both secure promotion and to demonstrate loyalty.
There is one incident which shows that the whole thing is organized at the very top level. The incident is connected with the member of National Assembly from Prosperous Armenia Party, Garo Karapetyan. He visited us and me personally in the polling stations. And he asked me to collect my people and leave Artashat because some of the polling stations are under his responsibility, and if he doesn't make sure that the incumbent president gets enough votes, he will have problems. He continued persuading me and I said, sorry, I cannot help you in the ways you want me to help you. He also knew the names of other observers from our organization and where they were deployed. So next he visited some of them and suggested that they should leave the polling stations. To one of them he was very frank, to Narek Babayan. He said, well, you need to help me. I need to do ballot box stuffing here. And that was in polling station 17-2. But everybody rejected his offers.
I just know what I observed as an observer, and I know what my friends observed as observers. There was guided voting, there was multiple voting for different persons. And even with these old violations, Serge Sargsyan got only 54% of vote in our precinct, which was in Ararat, in a village in Moscow. And Rafi has got a lot of votes, and Serge Sargsyan didn't get more than 50, definitely. If there were no violations, he wouldn't win.
Մենք այսպեսի արտահայտությունը տեսել ենք, որ լցոն են, լցնեն, փոխեն, բայց ասած չեն, չենք տեսել։
Hi, my name is Narna Smiley. I'm a volunteer with Transparency International here in Armenia with the Birthright program. I was an observer at the presidential elections yesterday, February 18, 2013. I was stationed in Artashat village, 17-5 district. As soon as the voting process started, we noticed that a few people, my partner and I noticed that a few people were coming in more than once to vote. We stopped them, and also some people came in with false identification passports belonging to other people or passports that already had stamps in it. Around 2:30, a group of people walked in. I told the officer, the police officer that was standing by the door, to make sure that only 15 people came in at once, because that's the rule. Then I noticed around 25 to 30 men also walked in. They surrounded the ballot box in which the secretary was sitting next to. I approached them, I grabbed one of the men's arms to tell them not to touch the ballot box. He pushed me against the wall and held my hands like this. And from where I was standing, I was able to see that the secretary of the commission cut open the ballot box seals, and one of the men poured a bag full of ballots into the box. She resealed it and they ran out. When I approached the secretary and told her why she asked her why did she allow such a thing to happen, and I asked the proxies, even the proxies of the other party members, why they would allow such a thing to happen, and they just simply told me that nothing happened and they didn't see anything in it. They don't know what I'm talking about. I was also told it would be a good idea to call the police station and see if they had any suggestions of what to do. When the policemen arrived, the village leader came along with them, and ironically enough, his son was the one who had pushed me against the wall. The village leader, as with the cops, they surrounded me against the wall, and they told me that I'm a good girl and that if I don't want any trouble, especially considering that I'm a foreigner from America, that I should refrain from saying anything else about the cheating process, and I should refrain from saying anything about Serge Sarkisian's campaigning process. But after the incident, it seemed like the ballot box doubled, so I guess about 400, 500 were stuffed. When all the counting for all the candidates were done, the numbers of the signatures, the numbers of the ballots, the numbers of the envelopes left over did not match at all, even with their cheating. So it was obvious that something had gone wrong.
And did you report this to the OSCE?
Yes, they came around in the beginning of the day and they saw that there were no major problems, so they left. But when they found out what had happened to me and what happened to my partner in our bowling place, they came back in secret at first. I met them at the side of the building. Then they realized that I might be in danger, my partner might be in danger, and the polling place was just a mess. So they decided to come back during the counting of the votes, and they witnessed the ballot box being opened, and they were shocked to what happened. They were in disbelief that such a thing could happen.
And were the OSCE, in their statement today, did the OSCE acknowledge this event at all?
No, they did not, even though this was probably the biggest cheating in all of Armenia.
Dermot Ahern, the Irish observer, shared with me how they were counting, in his words, Rabbi, 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 Serge, Rabbi, 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 Serge, that all day, all of a sudden, they first laughing, they were laughing about it, but then they start getting nervous, and then they panic, and they have to stop it. Those voting precinct stations, if you will, perhaps ought to be manned or monitored by truly disinterested, objective parties, whether it's the Europeans, whether it's the Armenians of the diaspora. I don't know the answer.
The problem is that there are many, many eligible voters that remain on the voter list who are no longer in Armenia. And this list of voters who cannot vote in absentia, because Armenia does not have the law or mechanism to do that, this list of voters is a tool in the hands of the authorities to basically manipulate the vote any way they want.
The number of voters, according to the official numbers, was 1.5 million about. So Transparency International had a system to count in that number how many minutes people will need to do their voting, and they counted that in about in 101 polling stations. The voting was during 40 seconds, which is actually impossible. A person cannot get a ballot, signed the ballot, and then go to the voting room and vote, and then come back and stamp and put the voters list to the box. So this is really impossible.
The unlevel playing field was largely defined by an inflated and very inaccurate voter list, where ironically there are 200,000 new voters in Armenia on the rolls registered since the last presidential election. For a country like Armenia, where demographically we're suffering from a mass exodus of people on an annual basis, this is an obvious and very questionable reality in terms of fixing by registering either unknown or illegal voters in Armenia.
Who would do such a thing?
Well, the Armenian police, of all institutions, is the one body and probably the only country in the world that is responsible for the integrity and for the enforcement of voter registration.
The police are policing themselves?
But it's a huge opportunity for fraud, because if you have up to one-third of the voters not in the country, someone can vote their name.
They're professionals. They've been doing it for 20 years. And when you know how to change the vote, to allow somebody to vote twice,
yes,
for someone who is absent, who doesn't live, there are 700,000 or so, yes, Armenian citizens who aren't here. Many of them were voted for.
The voting lists are not being published, the signed voter lists. And this gives the authorities to commit all sorts of electoral fraud. And the mechanism is very simple. It is done by the members of precinct electoral commissions. According to the law, there should be a rotation of functions. And every 2 hours, the members of the commissions should change. But in many, many polling stations, two members of the commission fill in the voter list from the beginning until the very end. And these are the people who know all the people in their communities, and they know if they are out of the town or if they are ill or for many, many reasons, they know who is not coming. Armenia is a small country. So a neighbor or a relative or a friend would very well know that this person was not in Armenia, but somebody voted instead of him or her. So the purpose is to hide those voter lists so that there is no check afterwards. And the votes of these absentee voters are used for these extra votes that the authorities ensure by means of ballot box stuffing or human carousel.
There are a number of researchers both inside Armenia and outside, starting from a researcher who is very well known professional in the field of electoral fraud from Columbia University, and ending with Russian statisticians. They issued results of this kind of analysis, and all of them actually came to the same conclusion that there is a significant indication of fraud.
It's very telling that Serge Sarkisian has refused to open the 1900 ballot boxes.
Electoral commissions had 5 days that they could do recount. They didn't open any single precinct with these strange results to prove that, see, there are ballots, and this was the results. Republican Party members and president himself was telling all the time that these are the best elections of Armenian history and we are going to do everything to prove it. They did not do a very simple thing to prove this.
Police or KGB, they can find that violations. It is really easier to do that for them than for me, than for any opposition part or for any other groups of people, but they're not doing it.
Why?
Even when we show them that violations, yeah.
Why don't they enforce the law?
Because the government has a problem. The police and KGB and other governmental structures, they are under the control of Serge Sarkisian, and it's, let's say, forbidden for them to do to fix that violations, forbidden not by law but by oral orders of Serge Sarkisian.
Այն ասենք սեփական իր չեն գործակալական ցանցի կամ պետ բյուջեից ծախսող միջոցների հաշվին ոստիկանությունը իմացել կանխել գնացել ասենք բացահայտել եք ու պատժել գոնե մեկ դեպք եթե
արձանագրվել 88 հաղորդում որոնցից 17-ի հերնակ քաղաքացիներն են կամ հավանական անձին մնացածները զանգվածային գրաքննիչների նշանակների դարձումների հարցում.
Even when we call them and inform them this building someone is giving an election bribe, we call them half an hour ago and they say, oh yeah, we visited that building and we didn't find nothing.
Do you think in that case they're just lying?
Of course.
According to the latest report of ODIHR, International Observers, there were around 300 possible offenses, but the Prosecutor General initiated criminal proceedings in some 10 of them out of 300.
By doing this, they display protectionism towards the criminals, towards the people who committed electoral fraud, and the clear message to them is, don't worry, keep helping us and you will have no problems.
But the government doesn't care. I mean, these days it's not so shame to violate the law. Yeah, it's like, yeah, we can violate the law, we're violating it. If you can, you can violate it too, but we're gonna arrest you.
So some improvements over previous elections, but still some problems, some serious problems of vote buying, serious problems of the misuse of administrative resources to favor the government party.
Election fraud has become more sophisticated and has become more hidden, and it's not as easy to observe, especially on the part of foreigners who come into the country and try to understand what's going on in that context.
Welcome, good morning. Welcome to the press conference of the OSCE Parliamentary Assembly Observers.
Compared to previous presidential elections, and that matters, this election is a step forward.
Could you say why you think this was a step forward?
Yes, of course, gladly. We tried to compare situation within the country in comparison with the situation before. This year, presidential elections, of course, despite the some problems which government and the legislature this country must address, is a serious step ahead.
As you know, as much as many as one-third of the voters are living outside the country, it's seen by many people as a huge opportunity for stealing votes, have people vote in these people's names. What is the best way of closing this huge gap right here?
If I'm informed correctly, so far we did not see, or it's not reported, that on these elections it can be, let's say, a major problem to recognize the result of the elections. But problem persists, of course.
There are 2,000 stations, there's 12 hours, something can happen in 10 minutes. We saw in Russia where the fraud took place very quickly behind the scenes.
I was very discouraged seeing some of the performance of the election observers with their long lunches, even on election day, similarly disengaged, counting the per diem more than the votes.
Have you registered major violation during the vote?
We have noted some instances of violations, such as a few cases of vote buying, unsealed ballot boxes. Let me think. I need to see my report, yeah, because these are figures that came just in freshly.
I guess you were saying that some proxies.
No, no. Can we stop this question?
We need to make our voice heard internationally, so we found it suitable to express our opinions during the ODIHR and OSCE elections report to overcome that barrier.
Lena came to the stage and she started talking. They wanted to make her silent, but we were there, we made her speak.
The recent presidential elections in Armenia, when compared to previous presidential elections, has taken one step forward and three steps back, two steps to the right and half step to the left. In a nutshell, they haven't corresponded to the Republic of Armenia Constitution, to the demands of the election code as well as international standards. The elections have proceeded against the backdrop of proposed reforms to the election code by the parliamentary opposition, which is rejected by the ruling majority. Even though international and domestic observers, human rights defenders, and the opposition raised concerns, especially regarding glaring inaccuracies in the voter rolls, after the parliamentary election, the ruling authorities still did nothing to fix the problem before the recent presidential election.
Do you think they might change their mind in the final report?
I think yes. They have to.
Մենք մերժել ենք ՀՀԿ-ի ընտրությունների վերաբերյալ իրականությունը չարտացոլող հաշվետվությունները.
Will there be democracy in Armenia?
Sure, because we are here to build democracy.
All kind of civil activism is encouraged by OSCE.
Why are all these people here?
Because they want to go to OSCE office and do their protest.
Գիտենք որ այս ընտրությունները զանգվածաբար կերսել են։ Ուդիտորների կողմից հաստատի լեգիտիմացում է, օժանդակում է իշխանություններին կատարել այդ կերպը եւ լեգիտիմացել կերծված ընտրությունները։
Ինչ որ
մի ռոպե շուտ լքել Հայաստանը եւ ընդհանրապես էլ չգա։
he's saying that this action doesn't permit people to enter the building and doesn't permit the people to cross the street. That's why it's necessary for the people to cross the street and continue the action on the other side.
Circling, they're circling.
Here they come. Hi guys.
He's saying that we have right to say whatever we want.
How is it possible that we, ordinary citizens of the Republic of Armenia, have seen so many violations? And those observers, what they were doing? They were eating horvats on Proshan Street.
What the OSCE thinks they're doing is helping the democratic process. Where actually it's a doubly negative impact, because not only are they teaching the government that it's really easy to fraud and get grants, they're just teaching the government to go through more sophisticated ways of fraud as opposed to actual democratization. By giving out a press conference less than 12 hours after the polls closed, they're complicit.
A few foreigners, the observers, came out of the office and they said, we want to meet you. Good. And we want to receive whatever you have.
They're not against us being there with our posters.
So it's just the police that are blocking the people.
It's the police just blocking people down there, blocking not only the protesters, but everyone.
Do you think the police have orders from someone to block them?
I guess.
What we'd like to do is just talk to these people so that we can defuse this and everybody can go home. They can give their messages that they want to do to us.
Գնում ենք, հանձնում ենք նվերները ԵՀԱԿ-ի դիտորդներին. Ուրեմն սա այն ծրարներն, սա այն ծրարներն, նա պատառոտված, որոնք տեղի են ունեցել ընտրությունների ժամանակ. Սա ԶԼՄ-ներում հրապարակումներն է, թե ինչպիսի ընտրություններ են եղել Հայաստանում. Եվ սա այստեղ, այս կրիչի վրա, զետեղված են բոլոր այն խախտումները, որոնք տեղի են ունեցել այս ընտրությունների ժամանակ. Խնդրում եմ ծանոթացել և եզրակացրեք, թե արդյոք այս ընտրությունները մի քայլ առաջ էին, թե քանի քայլ հետ էին.
Thank you.
This next movement that's coming along, the students boycotting school and going to classes, I think this is a great movement. It shows initiative, and Rafi's smart by not backing it necessarily, but saying it's a legal right of the students not to take part in anything but legal and civil disobedience.
We want just to change the system and to start a new revolution of students.
So where are we going now?
We're going to State Medical University, where is now protest, where are now students from other universities.
Students are joining some not because of the university, because of the administrators. They don't let them to join us. They're afraid of their administration.
Հայաստանի ապական դուք է, երկասարտերն են կարուցելու։
Ոչ մի խթեր, ոչ մի սպարզալեք, չէ կարող մեզ վախոցնել, մենք բոլորս ձերտեմած ուսանողներ ենք։
Today we want to really develop a real democracy, and I'm so happy this is coming, and we feel the real owners of the country. We have to say no to this corrupt regime.
Everyone wants freedom, but there are many people who are afraid of
fighting.
Yes. Stupid.
We want justice, and that's the important thing.
I want our government to go away.
We do have civil disobedience, where instead of maintaining the status quo, the level of discontent and civic activism may converge on actually challenging the unacceptable behavior of many in the government and challenge the arrogance of power.
If every person will try to do something, will try to express the all emotions and all truth, they will win. Otherwise, we will lose last chance to save our country.
Stop shopping at the oligarch-owned businesses, stop buying their products, stop drinking their waters. And then the next step from that is to stop doing business with known RPA businesses, restaurants, cafes, bars.
Because you're hitting them in their pocket.
In their pocket, yeah, absolutely.
There should be boycott against paying utilities, paying taxes if necessary, any kind of action that will repress the government from going about their daily work.
Ratchet up the pressure in that sort of way until Serge Sarkisian just feels it's uncomfortable, too uncomfortable rather, and he'll have to either call for new elections or run off or do something.
This situation can be resolved only with either a massive recount or second round.
These voter lists are not published. And until these lists are published, we will never be able to change our government by means of elections.
But when we have public demand and when we have strong public, which is not taking bribes, which is not being corrupted, then the elections will change as well.
If you have rule of law, won't many of the other problems be fixed?
Solved, exactly. And then the economy right. will be fixed because of the rule of law and also liberalizing the market, the getting rid of the monopolies, getting rid of the oligarchs and the commodity-based cartels, getting rid of a lot of bad stuff that is in the country.
The solution is no longer a person. The solution requires systemic change. And in many ways, if it's an experimentation with even outsourcing judiciary.
There should be a separation of power between the executive and the judiciary.
Take the power away from the president appointing the judges, even outsourcing judiciary if it's necessary, to take time to build up the understanding of what the judiciary system is and why it should be independent.
And I see help coming from different directions. Diaspora is one big serious place where I see potential. But then I see potential in things like European Union, Eastern Partnership, the Council of Europe, which are putting there some conditions and are trying to put some world order.
Diaspora Armenians should consider coming and doing observation in Armenia. Because firstly, they know Armenia very well. Secondly, the majority of them do not have a language problem. And this will be of huge help to Armenians living in Armenia.
I think the ultimate thing is spend 10 days in Armenia. You'll learn so much so fast, and then in between the learning, you'll also have a good time.
Armenian leadership never had political will to conduct free and fair elections and to provide independent judiciary for the citizens of Armenia.
Why was there no political will?
Because if elections are free and fair, then they will lose the authority. If judiciary is independent, it means they will be punished for rigging elections, for falsifying elections.
Քաղաքական իրավիճակի փոփոխության ժամանակ ես ձեզ վստահեցնում եմ, որ այդ խորհրդանը շատ գեղեցիկ ձևով ինքնակամ, հոժարակամ կլուծարվի եւ նոր խորհրդանական ընտրություններ.
Հեղափոխական տրամադրությունը այսօր համակել է ամբողջ հասարակությանը, այդ թվում իշխանությունը, որը հայտարարեց, որ ինքն էլ ուզում է համանդրական հեղափոխություն իրականացնել, այնպես որ հեղափոխությունը ամեն դեպքում լինելու է.
One option may be like the British do, form a shadow cabinet to actually begin confronting the government beyond the election, policy by policy.
I am a strong supporter of a different form of a government. It is a parliamentary government.
Ուստիև անհրաժեշտ է, որ փոփոխություն դիտի եւ կառավարման պարլամենտական եղանակին մասնենք, հատկապես հաշվի առնելով այն հանգամանքը, որ ներում պատմություն ապացել է, որ փոքր երկրները որպես օրենք պարլամենտական կառավարման համակարգին են ասում եւ ավելի արդյունավետ են դա կառավարման առումով.
There will be better checks and balances via parliamentary system. At the core, of course, it is important that Armenia turn into a nation that respects the rule of law.
I guess it's a really good system. It's working in many, many countries. When it's coming from one man, it's more, there are more risks against the democracy than when it's coming from parliament.
Armenia needs a parliamentary republic not to have authoritarian rule, because the current system of public administration and the structure of state itself strengthen authoritarian trends in the republic.
It should be checks and balances. If you make sure that the government is free, is elected free and transparently, then the parliament would be also elected from the people, and people should delegate others to govern the country, not just the president alone.
I'm very skeptical about transforming from a presidential to a parliamentary system. Given the nature of today's Armenian parliament, both in terms of ineffectiveness, oligarchs as deputies, the institution itself is not yet capable of actually either balancing an overly dominant executive branch, nor is it ready to actually govern the country. It may make things worse, actually.
When you have no democratic tradition, you must have a good laws and constitution.
They came here for protests of free parliaments.
Is it possible to change the government? Is it possible?
Everything is possible.
There's something called the pre-parliament here in Armenia. It's like an alternative parliament that's being set up by activists. What is your expectation from that kind of situation?
It's worth a try, of course, but it's actually fundamentally challenged because in order to elevate the discourse and debate, media and public education are important elements, which to date would be serious challenges for such an initiative.
They are trying to form a shadow government that is receiving the popular vote, and in due time present that to the existing government and say, look, you guys are out, we're in. And it is within their rights in the Armenian constitution to organize and do this.
They are trying to create a complete new system for our country, because we know the current system doesn't work, and we all know that you can try to change little things here and there, but the country really needs everything reinvented, renewed. Just pretty much we need to start from scratch.
Yes, ինչ է փաստը։ Ես Երևանում քայլում եմ։ Ինչ մի ընդհան։ Ձերբակալեկին։ Ձերբակալեկին։
Was Gargan Chukasisyan arrested after the rally? He is the head of the pre-parliament.
He is a pre-parliament member and he was arrested. But of course, as usual, they arrest him and then a few hours later they released him, because they know the people are going to demand them to release, you know, their leaders.
And diaspora, he put money for school, for social program, but for democratic change, it he no support.
The diaspora is beginning to see Armenia differently, to see the real challenge of Armenia, much less willing to not criticize shortcomings in Armenia, much more willing to challenge and to hold to account.
They laugh at the diasporans who go and pay $400 or $500 a plate, and that money goes in their pocket. Yeah. So they have to know that the diasporans are understanding that they are thieves, that they are murderers.
So why are you protesting? What's the number one reason?
Well, the number one reason is there's been election fraud this time, and it's been the worst kind of election fraud that we've seen in Armenian history. Just blatant election fraud. And thanks to smartphones and video cameras, we've got a lot of documentation. It's compelling and it's a very motivating evidence that's out there. So basically what we want to do is we want to get word out to the people of the world that there's a problem and we can't be complacent.
Well, we do have the largest Armenian community outside of Armenia, so I think it only makes sense that we do more frequent events in LA. And I really think it's important for citizens in Armenia fighting for this cause to know that we are next to them and we're not ignoring the cause, mm-hmm. and that we are supporting it 100%. I'll see you guys in Armenia.
We're an inseparable part of the Armenian reality. And whether we live here or live in Armenia, it's inescapable that we care. And regardless of what anybody tells us or anybody tells you, this is not a hopeless fight. And this is a fight for the future of Armenia.
I personally was evicted from my home, and the lady, my neighbor who lived next to us, she passed away from a heart attack because her belongings were still inside when her house was bulldozed and bought by the oligarchies. This is a great pain for our people. We're a peace-loving people, and they have taken advantage of that. They have taken advantage of our kind heart and our patience, but it is time that this corruption ends. We cannot afford anymore.
The diaspora is one with Armenia wherever we are.
The Armenian people are going to take charge of their own country on April 9th.
Այսօր գերազդյատում է վաղը ժողովրդի հաղթանակն է, շնորհավորում եմ բոլորին եւ մեր հայրենիքը, որտեղ քաղաքացին եւ ոստիկանը, լրագրողը, գյուղացին, քաղաքացին արդեն հասկացել է, որ Սարավի հաղթանակը չի ոչ ոք ծերջի պատմությունը, իսկ հիմա ժողովուրդը հաղթել է եւ ողջունում են ժողովրդի հաղթանակը։
Ժողովրդի համար աշխատել
ենք,
սկսել այսօր եմ ես նորից սրան հավեսել եմ մերակ գողանալով։
The government may overreact. We may see the return of a very violent and deadly clash. Every day has become a March 1st anniversary.
On April 9th, the people took an oath to love our fatherland, to never be disillusioned or disappointed, that this is a long-range struggle for freedom, for liberty, for democracy, and for the national interest, that is based not on one person, but on the national will. On April 9th, we decided not to be disappointed, or to criticize, or to go home, or watch a soap opera on the computer, but to commit ourselves to the future of Armenia, and we will see that future together.
Armenian people should just stand for their rights and keep fighting for them.
I can do something to change something in my country, to make it better.
Ծնվում եք քաղաքացի, մեծատառով քաղաքացի, որը գիտակցում է իր պատասխանատվությունը.
Eugenius?
No, I'm just a civil activist.
Եվ այդ քաղաքացին վաղ իսկապես իր ավարտական կերպարով Հայաստանի կփրկի, Հայաստանի զարգացման ճշգրիտ ուղին։
Բոլոր քաղաքացիներ Հայաստանի Հանրապետության պետք է ակտիվ լինեն այդ թվում։
Ակտիվ քաղաքացիներ։
The atmosphere is getting more and more progressive and people are learning more, opening their mind and standing up for their rights as citizens. And I think that's what democracy is all about.
People can unite. As I can see, there are some signs of it happening now, and to take care of their power to build democracy in Armenia.
I would say that there is the, the seeds of the democracy, which is us. And it's up to us to grow. And we will grow. Doesn't matter even if the Armenia is a mountainous country and it's a rocky field, so we'll still eat grow. A lot. Yeah, we will grow even in the stone, but we will make it.
If freedom is in the heart of people, then something will change.
We think that we should start by little steps. So little goal, and then big goal at the end.
Even small changes will make big changes.
The small ways all put together bring big results. We should not be thinking that nothing will happen. Something will happen, and it will be good.
That really doesn't take many and doesn't take much for true change. If there's opportunity, which is now being created, and if there's political will, which is now coming largely from the opposition.
For the first time, probably in a generation, we have a group of well-educated, fearless, devoted youth. And these are the guys that are going to make the change. They have very little backing. Some of them are completely self-reliant, but the powers that be are more afraid of these kids than these kids are of them.
Ես կարծում եմ ոչ թե հիմա մենք եկել ենք այստեղ փոփոխություն ենք պահանջում, այլ արդեն մենք փոխել ենք մեր երկրում մթնոլորտը եւ մեր մեջ ենք փոխվել. Արդեն մենք հաղթել ենք.
Civic activism at this stage is now so dynamic and the momentum is so significant. There's no retreat.
I'm surprised that after all the events since 2008, the people again were so smart to come out and to take a stand for their vote. So I think, yes, Armenia has changed forever.
The most significant lesson for the Armenian government is that it's now become very dangerous to ignore popular demands for change. And this is what today's about.
Change is coming.
Yes.
Do you think your vote was counted?
Actually, I'm not thinking in that way, but I'm sure that it will be counted if we have a legal government, if all the steps are going to be legal, not like nowadays voting system. And I'm more than sure that we will have an excellent country, the one that we dreamed about.